Coach, on senior day, you guys came out, defensive flying around, did a great job in the first half. Tell me about what you guys did defensively in the first half that worked so well.
The first half of the Moorhead game, we kind of employed a little bit of the bend but don't break philosophy. I wouldn't say that we came out and just stuffed them by any means, but they were able to move the ball a little bit, but then we would stiffen up and we created some turnovers. We forced a long field goal that they missed. Gave our offense good field position. We were able to score some points off some of that field position as well. So I just think that that we kind of learned how to play that field position game. We took advantage of it and really gave ourselves an opportunity to jump out to that 13-0 lead at halftime. I think if we could have that game back, we would have converted two of those touchdowns instead of them being field goals. But anyways, I think the best part about it was we started to play a little bit more team football where offense and defense kind of play off of each other.
How about the goal line stand in the third quarter? Talk about those series of plays.
Yeah, coming out in the second half, we knew that they were going to throw the ball a little bit more. I mean, they weren't having any consistency moving the ball in that first half. They were able to have some success on the pass. We were pretty keyed in on stuffing the run, and our underneath coverage guys, our linebackers, were really focused in on the run. We kind of lost some of those receivers back behind us. But then once we got them down in deep into the red zone, once they tried to bring in some bigger body personnel, which isn't 100% who they are. I mean, they're more of a four wide receiver type team. That's where they have their success. We were able to get some of our bigger bodies in, and we were able to apply some pressure. Created a huge stop on the fourth down there, Bryce Broom with that big tackle for loss. And unfortunately, it's a double-edged sword. I mean, we stopped them and held them out, got the ball back for our offense, but we were definitely put in a pretty deep hole. We weren't able to dig ourselves out of that one. And so then when we punted, it gave their offense another good opportunity with good field position. So it was a good stop. Unfortunately, it still kind of played into their field position game.
Zach Kuna is one touchdown away from tying the program record. Excuse me, two away from breaking it. Is he aware of that heading into this last week? I'm sure probably has it in the back of his mind.
He may be aware of it. I wasn't aware of it until you just said it. So that's kind of neat to hear that. And it's at the right time. I mean, Zach's been playing pretty good football here as of late. He was obviously his most efficient 2 weeks ago against Moorhead. Not as efficient as we want. A few too many balls that were incomplete. We started to get a couple drops in there, some crucial drops, unfortunately. But what Zach did show us on Saturday is that there's times he can be better, but then there's times that he can make a throw that I don't think there's a lot of kids in our league that can make those throws. The deep one there on the last drive of the game down the sidelines to Taylor Maloney from the opposite hash and just dropped it into the bucket. He's got those definite glimpses of greatness that he has. He just hasn't had a great consistent career, whether it's health or coaching or anything, unfortunately for him. But I'm sure he's aware of it, and hopefully that plays right into the game plan. That would be a really cool thing for him.
How much has his mobility really added to this offense this year, both actually design runs and extending plays?
Well, I'm a big proponent of a quarterback that can run and threaten a defense, and that's probably because of my defensive background. I know what gives me fits as a defense coordinator is a quarterback that can run with the football. And so, Zach's never going to be the most elusive quarterback in our league running with the ball, but he's not afraid to do it. And as long as he can pull it down on the reads and get positive yards, it's always going to be a threat to a defense. And he's had some really good runs for us, some touchdown runs and made the right reads and things like that. So that's really helped our offense.
How about being as close as you are, Coach? I know you've had four or five games this year that are right there. And another one now like this. For the younger players coming up, is this kind of that moment where you say, okay, this is the next step we got to take, we're this close and we got to finish it off?
Yeah, I think the positive of having those four games that were really close that we lost was that we can learn from those. And as we look at it, the game on Saturday against Moorhead, we lose by six. We obviously had a couple drops in the end zone right at the end that could have won the football game for us. We didn't win on Saturday, but I think those are the games that are gonna win us games down the road with our young guys. And I told our seniors that Saturday night. I said, you know, you won't get any credit 3 years down the road for this team when it starts to win more consistently. But you're breeding that in our youth. And it's frustrating because we're that close. But by the same token, you got to also step back and say, you know, last year, 2 years ago, 3 years ago, we wouldn't even be this close. And so it's definitely a positive that we're getting there. We still haven't gotten over that hump yet. And we're going to keep on pushing to get to it and see if we can still go out this last game and treat it like a bowl game and see if we can steal the last one.
Do you think with the guys that you have in this program right now, maybe as soon as next season, if you get those kind of situations again, you can hopefully notch some more wins?
I hope so. I mean, that would be the, that would kind of be the script that we've got laid out. I think we're playing a ton of youth, and that's going to help us. Our defense player of the game, Manuel Bradford was phenomenal for us on Saturday in his first college start. And he's one of, I want to say we have 11 or 12 true freshmen playing for us. And those kids are going to have to be our leaders. As you kind of forecast to next year, you know, we lose 20 seniors that are graduating that have been kind of our elderly, our guys that are kind of the glue for us, teaching our young guys the way. Next year right now, it looks like we have 4 or 5 seniors that will be here next year. So we've got to have all that leadership's got to come in from our young guys, from our youth. They got to embrace that and be able to push this program along in the right direction. But if we can learn from it, and now we get a full off season all together to keep building what we're trying to build, which is toughness and that type of thing, which that's really where you do it, is in the off season. I think we'll be better for it. I don't want to say we're going to win X amount of games, but I think we're going to learn how to be more competitive, and we're going to learn how to handle close games.
Cool. Coach, one last thing. Something else that you didn't know about, but you will find out a little later this afternoon. So Jose Luis is the NSIC Special Teams Player of the Week. So I want to talk about his performance on Saturday and how nice it is that, you know, you struggled with field goals early in the season and even extra points and how you stuck with him, how he stuck to it, and ends up with that kind of a reward.
Well, Jose Moreno was so crucial for us on Saturday. I mean, going 3 for 3 on field goals, you know, 1 for 1 on his PAT. Averaged 52 yards on punts. His kickoffs were, I think he averaged 59 yards a kickoff. I mean, I want to say there were 2 touchbacks and a third the kid brought it out from deep in the end zone. You know, Jose's got a major league leg. There's no question about that. And if he can be consistent with it, I mean, he's going to be really special by the time he's all said and done while he's here. And yes, it has been a rocky season for him. We go back to week 1 where we missed 3 field goals. In that game, we got shut out to Concordia, and you know, we would love to play that game again, not just because of those, but just from where we've gotten ourselves to this year. But Jose's been solid; he's handled it. You know, we've even against Mary, we bumped him down to number 2, try to get his brain right a little bit, and he's responded really well. He's come back; he was a little bit banged up. He's come back, and he's kicking right now the best that he's ever kicked since I've been around him, which is obviously the best time to do it. From what I was told, I guess apparently it's all coaching, because now my son's our kicking tee coach, so he gives Jose the tee in between every field goal and kickoff. So my son's really excited to take all that notoriety. But no, Jose's been phenomenal. If he can keep it up and keep his mind right, because they're kind of, kickers are like pitchers a little bit, you know. When they're doing well, don't talk to them, and when they're not doing well, you got to chew on them a little bit and know that they're going to probably shut it down for a while. But if he can do that, there's a lot of points that we haven't gotten in the past that we can get going into the future.